and welcome to the Hardison and Cochran podcast. In today's episode, North Carolina Workers' Compensation Board Certified Specialist Attorney Ben Cochran will be answering the question, what happens if my workers' compensation claim is denied in North Carolina? Now, here's Ben Cochran.
In North Carolina, if an employee is injured on the job, they report it to their employer, and they also are encouraged to file a Form 18, which is a notice of accident to be filed with the Industrial Commission, as well as sending a copy to your employer and also to the insurance company that may represent your employer. Once that claim is filed, the insurance company for the employer will set up a claim with themselves, and they will begin to investigate the claim to determine whether or not it is a compensable or covered accident in North Carolina. As they are reviewing this, they will get information from the injured employee as well as obtaining medical records from the medical provider. Those may be current or even past medical records. Once they've evaluated the circumstances of how the injury happened and what's being reported, they have to make a determination on whether or not they're going to accept it or deny it. Oftentimes, the claim is denied. If the insurance company decides to deny the claim, they will file a Form 61 with the Industrial Commission, and it will state the grounds for which they are denying the claim. In order to obtain benefits in a claim that's been denied on a Form 61, it will be necessary that the injured employee request a hearing with the Industrial Commission and have a determination from the Industrial Commission as to whether or not it is, in fact, a compensable or covered workers' compensation claim. So the next steps would be to request a hearing with the Industrial Commission, and then more likely than not, a mediation will follow the request for hearing. Mediations are a requirement in North Carolina prior to going before a deputy commissioner for an evaluation through the Industrial Commission. If the claim does not settle at mediation, it is at that point in time that within 2 to 3 months, the claim will be set for hearing, more likely than not in the county where the injury occurred. It will then be heard by a deputy commissioner who will ultimately hear testimony from the injured employee and any witnesses that they provide, and also hear testimony, more likely than not, from the medical practitioners that have treated the employee for their injuries. Ultimately, they will make a decision as to whether or not it is a compensable claim. And once that decision is made, it will depend on whether or not either party appeals the decision as to how much further it goes in litigation.
Thank you for listening to the Hardison and Cochran podcast. If you have any questions, feel free to contact the firm through their website at lawyernc.com. Once again, that's lawyernc.com. We hope you have a great day. Listening to this podcast does not create an attorney-client relationship between you and Hardison and Cochran. Hardison and Cochran does not accept new clients until obtaining a signed agreement. This podcast is for informational purposes only and should not be intended or taken as legal advice. If you have a legal matter, contact a licensed attorney in your state about your specific set of circumstances.